Hello friends, welcome to our channel, My Techno Journal. This is Srinivas. Today I want to discuss one topic that is expense report. And I'll cover what is expense report and why we use expense report in Oracle Fusion. And what is the process and business flow for expense report. So let us start. So guys, when an employee, when he has incurred some travel related expenses, which is called T&L, and they want to reimburse these expenses which they have done during their travel periods. So these expenses can be accommodation, airfare, and cab, car rentals, and breakfast, dinner, and all other which are covered in there as per the travel and T&L policy. Okay. As per their policy, they need to submit their expense report and get it reimbursed by the company. So that is why the functionality expense report is there. And in Oracle Fusion, how we can process expense report, how we can submit. So let us discuss these points. Go to my Excel sheet and I'll show you the process flow actually. And this is the process flow actually, the basic process flow of expense report. So employee, when they have completed their travel, they need to enter their expense report, and after that it should go for approval as per the approval hierarchy. And once it is approved by the concerned approvers, then it will go for audit approvals. That is basically the finance auditor need to approve if the expense has been made as per the company's expense and T&L policy or not. So once the audit approval is done, then the company will accept the expense report and will take the action to reimburse the payment. Okay, so that is the basic flow of expense report in Fusion. I will show you one such example in Fusion instance. So let me go to the Fusion instance and show you the one of the flow. So this is the home page. From home page you have to navigate to me. Okay, so that is me. From there you have to navigate to the tab called expenses. Okay, just click on expenses. So this will drive you to the expenses page. Okay, so this is the called expenses dashboard. From the expense dashboard, you can able to submit your expenses. So let me just tell you one thing, that before creating an expense report, you have certain necessary setups that you need to complete, like expenditure category, your expenses policy, audit policy, and all these things need to be there in the system so that your expenses flow will be run successfully. Okay. So one important thing I just want to show, that is Srini IMP, that is one of the employees. So your user, I am employee, and for me I am submitting my expenses report. Okay, in manage user, just I want to show you something, that is let me query my username. Here this is me, that is Srini IMP. So here just select the line, select here the employee, and just click on manage expense information. So here you need to give your default expense account. So when you create an expense report, So this expense account should default in your report. So that is mandatory. If you this expense account is not given here, then you will not able to create your expense report. So this is mandatory. Okay. And another thing, in case of approval, suppose you have created your rules, approval rules, that once you submit your expense report, it should go to your immediate line managers. So who is my line manager? Rath Kelvin. So that means once I have made my rules, I have created my rules in this way, that once I create my, submit my expense report, it should go to my manager. Okay. So once the manager will approve, then it will go for audit approval. Even the audit approval is not mandatory. If you have set up your system like this, like your expense report setup, that audit is mandatory, audit is required, then only it will go to audit. Otherwise, you can bypass the audit and it will go to directly, it will go for payment after your manager approved the expense report. Just close it. So let me create one new expense report. So create report. Okay. The purpose is travel. Travel 3. Okay. And my payment method. So there are so many payment methods. You have to check your payment method here, in which way you want to get it reimbursed. Okay. And then just create your, I have read and accepted, just click on this. I have read and accept the corporate level and expense policies. So as per your expense policies only, you have to submit your expense report. It should not be out of scope your expense policy of your organization. Okay. So create your expense line. Okay. So you have to create your expense template, which will capture all the attributes of your expense related things. Okay. So I have my expense US1, that is my template I have created. Okay. Type. So these are the expenditure type you can select, like for which expenses you have to submit your expense report. Suppose I have to select car rental. So whatever car rental expenses I have incurred during my travels, so that need to be reimbursed. So I am submitting for these expenses. Suppose it's 2500. Okay. Cost centers. The cost center also you can choose here. So this is by default, it is showing your default cost center, and you can change it if it belongs to different cost centers. So I have changed this cost center so that whatever expenses, it will hit to that cost center only. Okay. So now save it. Here you can see if your expense report, you are referring to some project. Okay, if you are integrated with project accounting and if you want to cost these expenses to particular projects, so you have to give your project related details. That is called POET, or project number, tax numbers, and all these details you need to provide here. Okay, so now close it. After saving, you can close it, then submit your expenses. So once you submit, it will generate one expense report number. Okay. So that you can search here. Okay. just click on this arrow mark, you will be able to see all the expenses report you have submitted. So that is, just now I have created one report that is called travel 3. The purpose is travel 3. So it is generated automatically one expense report number, which is now current status is pending manager approval. So what is the next step? So I have submitted my expense report, and it will go for my line manager approval. Okay. So my line manager should able to see this in their in his notification, approval notification, and should approve this expenditure. Should approve this expense report. Okay. So let me log in into the line manager account. Just sign out. So my manager name is Kelvin Rath. So this is my manager account. I have logged in, and I will go to this notification window, and you can see here the expense report approval of this particular number is pending. So either the manager can approve or reject after reviewing my expense report. So let us click on approve. Okay, acted upon. So manager's work is done. Now sign out from manager login. Login to again my employee ID. So let me see what is the status. What is the current status of this expense report? So now it is pending manager approval. So manager already approved. So just wait for some time, it will be approved. The status will change. Yeah, you can see now the status is ready for payment. So that means once my line manager approved the expense report, it went to the accounts payable department for payment. So they will review the expense report and will pay the amount. The audit part I have skipped because I have not set up audit, so that is not required for my flow. You can, if you want like audit for expense report, that also you can implement here. Like after the manager approval, it will go to audit team for the audit, then only it will go to accounts payable team. So in my case, it is directly going to AP. So now this is ready for payment. So now I have to interface this details, interface this expense report to Oracle AP. So what I can do, how I can interface this detail to AP? So there is a seeded report you need to run. So go to navigate to schedule process. Schedule new process. Okay. So this is the seeded report you have to run, so that whatever detail like expense detail you have requested, so that will be interfaced to Oracle AP. So the report name is process expense reimbursements and cash advance. Okay. So click on OK and submit this report. Business unit, I can just select my business unit, that is US Business One, because I am the employee of Business One, Business Unit One. So that is expense reimbursement, not cash advance, because I didn't have any cash advance. Submit. Just wait for the program to be completed, then you will be able to see this expense report in Oracle AP dashboard. The program is completed now. So let me go to payable. Payable invoice. And just click on the recent. You can see just now we have migrated one invoice from expenses, and the accounting status is unaccounted and paid status is not paid. Just click on the invoice number. The next activity the AP team can do, these are all the normal regular activities that you have to validate. Okay, sorry. So go to invoice action and validate the expense report. So now the expense report is validated. Now create payment for this expense report. So pay in full. Bank account, I will select Bank of America. Payment process profile, the standard profile I will select. Standard check format. Payment document, that is check stocks. Okay. So these are the mandatory information I have provided, payment information, and click on submit. So let us see the invoice status now. So now we can see the amount has been paid successfully. So now let us go to the expense report again and see whether the status of this expense report has been changed or not. So it should be changed to paid. Earlier it was ready for payment, but now the status should be changed. So navigate to expense and just search for your expenses. Okay, so travel 3, so this one you can see the status is changed to paid. Okay, the status is paid. So this is all about expenses flow, like from expense how you can submit and how you can get approval and how you can migrate and interface it to Fusion AP and get it paid or get it reimbursed. So once the payment has been completed, once the payment will complete in AP, the here in expense itself the status will be changed automatically. So that is a basic flow of Oracle expenses. There are certain other criteria and other aspects of expenses. I will just cover it in a different session. So for now, that's all. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this video. So if you have not subscribed to our channel, please subscribe and click on the bell button to get latest update. And please comment and like our video and share to other people so that they can also learn how expense report can be submitted in Oracle Fusion. Thank you guys.